Right then, guys and gals, how's it going? It is Jace123 and today I'm here with a brand new video for you all. Now, basically in today's video, it's going to be sort of a different type of topic. Now, today's video is going to be me reacting to movie clips. So if you do enjoy this video, make sure to give this video a like, subscribe if you're on it, and leave your comments down in the section down below suggesting if any other ideas you want to see happen on this channel. So, let me tell you a mini sort of story. It's only short, but it'll basically do. While on YouTube recently, I was getting things recommended to me as movie trailers, because I like to watch movies, and I think some people like to watch them too, and probably a lot of you viewers at home like to watch them too. But I am particularly a massive fan of a franchise called Saw. Now, everyone may have heard of the franchise of Saw. If you haven't, it's basically like a cop killer detective sort of horror gore type thing. But yeah, I was looking around on YouTube for trailers to actually react to, and this came up in my recommended box, and I was so hyped about it because today's video we are going to be reacting to Jigsaw. Now, if you're wondering what Jigsaw is, this is basically the 8th installment of the franchise, of the Saw franchise itself. Now, I think it started in 2007, the first film when it came out, and it's now 2017, so that's 10 years that the actual franchise had lived on for. So this is the next installment of this video now. And also, one more quick thing to say, this is not a paid promotion or an endorsement. I've not had any contact with any people like Lionsgate or Twisted Pictures to actually release this. This is basically just me reacting to it like everybody else would do. So yeah, I've put it, let's just check to see if we're all in 1080. Yep, we're all fan dabby-dozy in 1080p. And yeah, let's get straight into this reaction video.
Now the game's simple. Best ones are. You want mercy? Play by the rules.
Any identification on the victim?
Puzzle piece.
But Jigsaw has been dead for 10 years.
It's not him. Can't be.
This was on the body.
The truth will set you free.
Help!
Chasing a dead man.
Just one escape.
The copycat.
He plays with you. So afraid.
Live or die. The choice is yours.
Just running.
You know what happens if we don't follow the rules?
The blood under the fingernails of our victim, John Kramer, the Jigsaw killer.
That's impossible.
Which one would you choose?
It was a game.
He was standing there.
The game's gonna be won. It's Jigsaw.
No, it's not creepy at all.
Alright, so we'll basically stop that one there. So, my first reaction and first looking at the trailer is, oh my god, like literally... That is amazing of what they've actually managed to do. And the way that they've portrayed the amount of horror and things into the franchise is just brilliant. They've always been a really good franchise for horror flicks and films. So, yeah, that's one of the pros about it. The cons are that with some of the traps, they kind of relate back to the old Saw. However, the pros are of this is that they're keeping the line of the whole Jigsaw thing, that Jigsaw used to use those traps and then bring them back, but more modified, so then it brings more, like, sort of things into the game. However, if we scroll through all of this, let's go past number 10, which was that, and we keep going.
Play by the rules.
With that one, I think, no, let's just keep skipping along, because I don't think that one is very good for what it looks like.
This was on the body.
The truth will set you free.
Like, with this one here, as you can see, if people do not know this particular trap, this basically looks like Saw 5 or Saw 6, where basically there were 5 people in a room, and Jigsaw said that 5 would become 1. Now, with this trap, it kind of looks like a makeshift device that, like, a 6-year-old would create. However, it's a really good idea. It gives more of the tension part. However, if we keep skipping along, that at the back of here, this wall part here that I'm probably not even putting my cursor over, but you probably won't be able to see, this part looks like something from Saw 5. Instead, they've modified this and put saw blades onto it instead of the triangular sharpened edge, which basically meant that in Saw 5 that they all were tied up, all 5 of them, and it wasn't a chain, it was actually like, I think it was wire or something, but they all had to reach a box, smash it, grab a key, and they would basically unlock themselves. However, by like 60 seconds, I think, or 2 minutes that they had, the person who didn't release themselves would be slung back and actually be decapitated. But with this one, it looks like they're taking a different approach, that 5 of them are all attached to the device, and that it's chained instead to show a bit more scare and horror. And also the chainsaws is like showing like sort of a different type of advantage in death, and it looks like that if they don't release themselves from these devices, that they're going to either be split in half or they're going to actually be killed by the saw blades and cut them. So yeah, let's just keep continuing on.
Chasing the dead man.
Like with this one here, as you can see, if people don't know which trap this was from Saw 2. Now, in Saw 2, this was called the Magnum Eyehole Trap that people had recommended this at. Basically, what happened was that there was a certain key, and one guy twisted it, and it shot, instead of actually thinking that it would open the door, it actually shot his eye out, so basically killed him. But this has only been used once, so I don't think it will be that bad to use it again. It just shows like a different contrast in like an older creation, but brought back way, way differently. So I'm happy about this one. So yeah, let's just keep going. All right, so with this one kind of does annoy me a bit, but it also surprises me that this trap, if you look very, very closely at it, it looks like the knife trap from, I think it was Saw 3? Yeah, Saw 3. And this is the one where Cecil was actually trapped in the knives, and his escape, his objective was to press into the knives with his face in order to escape. And this trap basically looks like that. Instead, it's got the spikes, and the knives are not facing front ways, they're actually facing, the knives were facing diagonal, so then he had to lean straight forward into them. With these, it looks like that in a certain amount of time, if no one survived, it would be pushed into the face and it would kill them. But that looks like what it would actually be. So yeah, let's just keep continuing on and see what other traps they have built into this. Okay, so if you're looking at this one here, this is the most famous trap of the Saw franchise of all time. Now, this is the reverse bear trap. This has been used on In Saw 1, it was used on Amanda Young, who was a drug addict, but now, when you get into the further on in the franchise, she actually becomes Duke's apprentice and helps him to succeed in his game. But this was also used in Saw 2, however it was modified, so basically the bear trap was bigger, it had the spikes instead of that which would retract. Instead of the bear trap pulling it open, it would pull and close in on the person in Saw 2, which was Michael. So I don't see anything wrong with this particular trap, but it's sort of like old and bog standard. I think it's either for decoration to show that this was one of the traps, this is like his workshop sort of place, or this could be actually used in the proper film itself. We know nobody fully knows yet. So yeah, let's just keep continuing on and see what other types of traps that they have.
Live or die.
Alright, so with this one, just as a quick thing, that this trap was actually used in Saw 2. However, this one, they've changed it up a bit. That in Saw 2, there was two sort of traps with this. It was also the razor blade trap, which basically a woman had to grab an antidote with this of a needle. Instead, if she didn't, she'd get caught in razors and she would potentially bleed to death and die. However, before that, it was basically that two characters, Amanda Young, who appears also in Saw 2, and a drug addict called Xavier, was meant to jump into a pit of needles with this particular type of thing, and was meant to try and retrieve a key to access a door. However, he decided not to throw himself in, and threw Amanda Young in to get the stuff. So, I think they're taking a different approach to the needle trap. Instead, they're just making it so it's like survival of the fittest sort of thing. So I'm happy about this particular one, but yeah, let's just keep going with it. Alright. Let's go back to the shotgun a second, because let's have a look. The shotgun, it's a pretty close glimpse, but if I see it at the right time, as you can see here, this is the shotgun. Now, if you're wondering what the shotgun trap was used from, this one was actually used in two things. This was used in Saw 1 on Detective Singh, and what happened was that he ran into a booby wire trap and the shotgun blew his head off, but also in Saw 3, which was basically used when Timothy was strapped to one of Jigsaw's personal favorite torture devices, which was called the rack. And what his aim, and what Jeff's aim was, the main protagonist, was that he had to grab a key and it would be used to unlock Timothy from the device that he was strapped to. However, you can see here, if you know more about the Saw franchise, that this actual shotgun itself was actually in a glass encased box. It also had two strings attached to it, so as soon as he got the key, it would pull and it would snap and shoot the shotgun. But it was meant to kill Jeff, but it didn't. It killed the priest instead, who was also a witness of his daughter's death, but never told. Jesus Christ, this thing's taking a bit too long. But yeah, that's that part out of the way. So yeah, let's just keep continuing. Alright, so one quick thing about this trap that I'm actually pretty happy with, like if I stop it at a close point here, you can see that throughout the whole thing, it looks like that it's set in an old abandoned farm, like a farmhouse or something. However, they've modified that to the point where it's going to work with any type of trap, like any type of ambition sort of thing. So I like the idea that they've actually used the idea of everything to their expectation, like this old, it looks like some type of thing where corn falls in or something, but it looks like the perfect sort of idea for like the encave, like closed in feeling. So yeah, let's just keep going on with it, because I'm starting to actually like these traps.
The blood under the fingernails of our victim, John Kramer, the Jigsaw killer.
That's impossible.
It was a game.
Right, so this one, that it looks like, as you've just seen from that particular thing, this is like one of the newest traps that they've actually built, and I think it actually looks pretty intimidating. It's pretty well made for what it is. Basically, it looks like that the wheel of the bike has been replaced with a cog, and the cog is spinning round instead of the wheel, and I think that the wheel looks like that if it keeps spinning, it's going to tighten the legs of the person, but if it stops, it may decapitate the person's legs and cut them off. However, I think it looks like a good trap. It looks like a good trap. It's very creative, and it's a new sort of way to bring more creativity and more terror to the actual franchise. So yeah, let's just keep going with this.
Thieves can be one. It's Jigsaw.
Alright, so I think with the idea of, just as a second, the idea of the Jigsaw red eyes is actually really, really intimidating. It shows to the audience that he is actually back and he is ready to like rock and roll with all the killing and stuff. And I like the idea of the chain situation. It shows like more of a more of an intimidating type of game sort of thing, that they can't get out, they can't move freely. But yeah, let's just keep going with this.
No, it's not creepy at all.
Alright, so if I go back to... wait a second, let me go back to this one. I wanted to know, what the fuck is that? Because I don't know if they're trying to make this more futuristic, or they're actually trying to make it so that normal things, not like saw blades and that, can actually kill you now in the Saw franchise. This looks like to me that that laser is attached to the guy's head, and that if it doesn't, if you don't get out in time or something, or risk something to actually escape, then things are going to move forward and they're going to slice his head straight through. It looks like to me. But I don't know about that one, to be honest, if it's, like, in my opinion. I think it's good, but it does get to the point of futuristic, so, yeah. Let's just keep going. Alright, so the one thing I want to know is... Yeah, she's got all the fingers, but I think it's just blood from somewhere else. So if I keep going... I think this particular trap that I can see right here, I think this is probably the end trap, because it looks like that... It looks like some type of mincemeat or something. Just as a random thought, but this looks like it's going to be the last trap of, like, when they get to the place, or the fourth trap, or the third, one of the two. But, it looks really creative, however, it does look, sort of dumb as well, because you wouldn't expect someone to get caught in a wire unless it's actually a booby trap, and you wouldn't expect someone to actually climb in there and be a booby trap, but... It does give a new idea of creativity, but yeah, let's just keep going with this. Well, I definitely think that the film itself has potential. I think when the film comes out on October the 27th of either 2017 or 2018, I will definitely be watching it. I think it will grab a way, way ton of audiences. Like... Way even before this came out, people were releasing Saw 8 fakes. They were basically putting like things like Hostel, they were putting like Saw 3 in that, and it just looked absolutely terrible when other people made them. But now that we know that Lionsgate have actually taken their time and effort to make this, and they know that they like that people like the Jigsaw franchise, that I definitely am going to be jumping back into the Jigsaw franchise and starting to watch this one when it comes out. So, yeah, that is basically it for this video. I hope you all have enjoyed. If you have, make sure to smash the like button, subscribe if you're new on it, and leave your comments down in the section down below suggesting of any other ideas you want to see happen on this channel. And, yeah, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you for your support, and I shall talk to you all in the next one. See you later, guys and gals. Take care, and peace out.